morning students, welcome to online class. This is Sheila, your computer science teacher. Today let us see IO operators. In previous class we saw assignment operator, conditional operators, relational operators, yes, logical operators, etc., isn't it? Today we shall see in IO operators. So what is IO? IO stands for input and output. So what is meant by input? See, we are learning about how to write programs. Yes, in beginning of all your sessions we started to know what is algorithms. Then we came to know what are all the types of keywords that we use, what is meant by identifiers, what is meant by literals and all, isn't it? Today we are going to see what is meant by operators. We already know what is operators also, but we are going to know about input output operators. Why do we use this input output operator? See, when we write a code, we need to get the input from the user as well. We wanted to print the output on the screen. Yes, when I do certain addition program A plus B, the result has to be printed in the screen. For such a case, what do? We go for input output operators. Yes, so for your input operator, we always have an symbol like this. Yes, this symbol is actually called as extract from or get from. Yes, it is nothing but a steam extraction or get from operator. Yes, it is a binary operator actually. Why do we call it as binary operator? Generally we will have two operators. What is meant by binary operator? Binary means two. Why do we call it as two operands we have? What is meant by operands? The variables that we have in the operation. Yes, so cn is going to be an variable. Yes, you will have an extract symbol along with a variable. This is going to be a variable for which the values is going to be obtained. Say for example, if I'm going to extract 10 will be assigned to A. How do I get it? From this, using this input cn. You should read it as cn and you should never call it as sin. Fine. So the first operand is a predefined operator, identifier cn, and that identifies the input device, the key that identifies the keyboard as the input device. The second operand must be a variable. How do we write? I wrote right cn, your get from symbol and a variable. Yes, so what happens, what variable it is going to be? C in num. So we are going to get value for num here. We are going to get value for num. Yes, so whatever value that I get, say for example, if I'm going to get 3 from the keyboard, if I press 3, that value will be assigned for num. Yes, now here what happened is we are getting two inputs. What are the inputs that we are going to get? We are going to get input for x and y. What are the inputs that we are going to get? We are going to get inputs for x and y. Yes, how do we get it? We get it from the extraction operator only, isn't it? X, y. So this is used to extract two values, cn, reach the first value and immediately assigns that to the variable x, and reach the second value and immediately assigns it to the value y. Fine, what is output operator? Output operator is otherwise, see, the symbol for your output operator is going to be like this. For your input it is like this. Yes, this is called as steam insertion or put to operator. Put to. Yes, how do you read this as? You should read it as C out and not as count. Fine. So what happens? Whatever I print, it has to be present in the monitor, isn't it? It has to be printed in the screen. Say for example, C out, your put to symbol and a variable expression. What happens? Whatever is going to be here will be printed in the screen. I know for you, for now it will be like listening to a Greek and Latin class. Very soon I will teach the same in your computer such that you will be able to understand what I am actually telling. Yes, so what happens is, and
to send more than one value at a time, you have this operator for each constant variable or expression. This is called as cascading operator. Yes. Now see out double quotes, we are giving it as welcome. So what is it actually? Anything that I give within the double quotes will be printed as it is in the screen. Anything that I give within double quotes will be printed as it is in the screen. Yes, and this is going to be your predefined variable. Yes. Fine. As well, if I wanted to print more than one value at a time, we will be using cascading operator. What does it mean by cascading? Several times you can use the symbol again and again to print multiple values together. See what have they written here? See out the sum, which it is actually given in double quotes, sent it, so it will be printed as it is in the screen. And if I didn't give anything and if it is going to be like this, this will not print as it is, but it will give you the value. Say for example, if I have given sum is equal to 3, 3 will be printed here and not the name. Clear? See out slash n area. So if I give slash n, what is it going to do? It means it is going to print in the next line. Yes, slash n represents the next line, new line. Next, what do you have? You have an expression here which has to be performed. What expression? 3.14 r into r. Say for example, if r is equal to 2, 2 2s are 4, 4 into 3.14. What is the value that we get? Will be printed as it is along with the area. The area. Yes, it will be printed like this. The area colon. The value of it will be printed here. Clear? And even I can make an addition operation here. How? C out A plus B. The operation itself will be performed here. And the result will be printed just like that on the screen. What about cascading IO operators? Till now we saw how to cascade input operators. If I'm going to give so many extension symbols together, it is going to be input cascading. And if I give so many put to symbol, it is going to be output cascading. And if I combine IO operators together, I mean your insertion and extraction symbol together, it is going to be your cascading IO operators. How it is actually done? Let us see. Input numbers, int num is equal to 20. This is how you have to give. Num is the name of a variable. 20 is the value that is being assigned for num. And this value is going to be of what type? Integer type. Int is nothing but your data type. Int is nothing but your data type. Next, what happens? C out. I am just printing A. A is equal to, it is given in double quotes, which is actually going to be printed as it is. And the value of num will be, what is the value of num here? 20 will be printed. Yes. This is cascading output statement. Now what is cascading input statement? C out, enter the number. Is this right? Not at all. It is actually wrong. It has to be given like this. C in. Okay. C in. Enter to. Or. It is not like that. C out. The symbol has to be changed. C out. Enter to numbers. Whatever is here will be printed as it is. The symbol is wrong. Okay. So what happens? Enter to numbers will be printed as it is like this. Next, what am I doing? I am cascading the input variables. It means I am going to get two variables in the same line. So C in A, first A value will be obtained 5, next B value is obtained, which is 6. Fine. A sample program. A first look at your C++. Now let us see a sample program. Interesting, isn't it? What have we done here using namespace standard? This here we have used Dev software. Dev C++ is a open source. You people can go to You people can simply go to Google page, just type it as Dave C++ free download, it will be available, you can download it generally, okay. It is an open source freeware. So after downloading, you will have a page where you can type and execute your program, a plain screen. In that, see, this is going to be a single line, single comment line. If I'm going to give something with double slash, it is going to be comment line. It will not be taken into account, it will be printed as it is. Yes, and hash include iostream.h is a header file. What it is actually? Header file for your C++. And for anything and every program, you have to give this using namespace standard. Now, if I'm going to use this in a licensed software like Turbo C++, there is no necessity for me to mention this namespace standard. Fine. Next line, what do you have? Int main. For any execution of a program, you should have main. Your execution will always start from main. And for any function, we call this main as a function. For any function, there must be a pod braces. For any function, there must be a pod braces. Whatever the function is. But this is the main default function. And your execution will always start from main. If there is a return type, you will have integer. And if there is nothing going to be returned, it is going to be void. Clear? Fine. So, see out. Welcome to C programming in C++. What will happen to this line? Any idea? Guys? Yes? Girls? What will happen to this line? Anything that is being given within a double quotes will be printed as it is. Yes? So, what will be the output now? Welcome to programming in C++ will be the output. Just have a look here. Welcome to programming in C++ is the output. Clear? So, double slash C++ program to print testing is a comment line, isn't it? Yes, hash include was a header file. I already told you, hash is a directive. It is a preprocessor directive. We call it as preprocessor directive, hash. Why do we use this? It is used for compilation. The statements of process before the compilation process just begins. Yes, for just starting the sequence, we have this hash. So what is the use of this hash include iostream.h? Iostream, it tells the compiler preprocessor to include a header file named iostream in the program. We already know that something few codes are already predefined in this, isn't it? So we have to include that in our program. Next, using namespace standard, it tells you the compiler to use standard namespaces. It collects the identifier used for classes, objects and variables. And this namespace provides the method for preventing the conflicts in larger projects. Int main. I already told you, right? So main is nothing but a, what is it? Every execution starts only from your main. Main is a function here. Yes, for any function you should have what braces? Pod braces. Welcome to C++. Anything that is being present in double quotes will be printed as it is. Since I am using int main, you should definitely have return 0 here. Yes, if I am going to have int main, I should definitely have return 0 in the statement. Now, execution of C++ code. For creating and executing C++, one must follow 4 steps. What are they? Creating a source code, saving a source code with the extension of CPP. Next, you have to compile the program. Then you have to execute the program. What are all the 4 steps that you have? You have to create a source code. It means you have to write a program. Writing a program, then you have to save it with a file name .cpp. Next, you have to compile the program. What is meant by compiling? Checking for errors and you will correct it in the compilation process. Once the error is over, the program has to be executed. Yes? Have a look here. What happened? A hash include, using namespace standard, int main, whatever is given there in the double quotes will be printed as it is. Yes, it will be printed. Once after the program is executed, the program has an independent existence. You can run it in any compiler or independent development environment. Any platform, you can run the exe file alone. Fine. So C++ development environment. See, there are a lot of independent development, integrated development environment, IDE, available for C++. Few compilers are going to be your Dev C++, Gini, CodeBlocks, CodeLite, yes, NetBeans, Digital Mass, Sky IDE, Eclipse. All these are going to be a free source which is there for your C++. Yes, your licensed software is your Turbo C++. So working with Dev C++, this is going to be your open source, and we are going to do all the programs only using Dev software. Among the dozens of IDEs, we take Dev C++ compiler to create C++ programs. Programming techniques and illustrator programs of this book are based on C++, Dev C++ compiler only. Dev C++ is an open source. It is a cross-platform, full-featured integrated development environment distributed with GNU. What is GNU? General Public University. It is actually for programming C and C++. It is written in Delphi. It can be downloaded. How can you download this? http://www.bloodshed.net/dev/devcpp.html. Nothing you need to do. Just get into your Google page, give it as Dev C++ free download. You can simply download it. Yes, after installation of Dev C++ icon, this is available on the desktop. Double click on it. Yes, it appears as shown. How will it appear? It will appear like this. Yes. Next, to create a source file, what do you have to do? Get into file, new source file, or get into control N. Then what happen? You will get a screen like this. In the screen, what you can do? You can simply type the code and get into file, file name, just get into file, save as. In that, just type it as file name dot cpp. You can give your own names for the program. Yes. Then what happens? After that, you have to compile it. Where do you have this compile? Get into execute, compile. The program will be compiled at first. When it is free of error zero warnings. Yes, then it means that, have a look here, zero error, zero warnings. It means the program is ready for execution. Yes, once it is successful, what happens? You will get a black screen in which the value will be printed. Welcome to programming in C++ is the output that you want, isn't it? It will be printed as it is. Clear? Now, there are three types of errors. One is going to be syntax error, the other one is going to be semantic error, the other one is going to be runtime error. What is syntax error? It is a grammatical error. Yes, grammatical error? Just have a look in this code. Welcome to C++. It seems to look like it is correct, isn't it? Every statement should end up with a semicolon. Semicolon is missing. See, for your C++, there are certain grammars that has to be followed. Since it is not followed, it means it is an error, grammatical error. What about semantic error? The program will be grammatically correct, but still it will not give you any output. It may be because of a wrong use of your variable operator or order of execution. Yes, that is going to be a semantic error. It is otherwise called as logical error. What is runtime error? And it will show you no errors, but during runtime it will show you an error, just like an illegal operations can take place. Yes, but that will be termed as a runtime error. Yes, children, we shall stop with this hands-on practice. You people try, but I'll definitely teach you in your next class. Thank you, children.